I'm Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. In this lesson, I've got one of the most fun chord playing ideas that the pros use all the time. It sounds flashy and it gets attention because it involves using scale tones played into and out of chords. Often it's called chord extras, frills, or embellishments, and it works by adding scale tones either before or after a chord. My old guitar teacher used to call this technique chord approach and following tones because it's adding those melodic lines either in front of or after a chord. Plus, you know what? It sounds great if you're just kicking back at home and playing guitar by yourself. After this, join me for the second half of the lesson over on my Patreon page, where I'm going to show you how to practice adding these chord extras and embellishments after the chords of a progression that I've written for you. Before we do that, I've actually created an easy-to-use practice routine that's going to help you visualize the interaction of scales with chords, and I've composed that extra example piece for you that's going to help demonstrate how cool all these techniques sound when you use them. But first, before we get started, I have a quick word I want to share with you about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. This lesson is going to be a lot of fun because it not only targets chord use for rhythm guitar, but it also gives options for bringing in scale tones that help highlight the chord from either above or below. Now, the scale lines and the chord harmonies for this lesson are all based around notes from A minor, and they use A minor scale for all the phrases on the approach and follow-up lines. I've created four examples of how this all works, so let's get started with the first example. We kick into it with a scale line, and then at the end of the measure, we get that triad chord on the top three strings. The scale line's really straightforward. We just have a fourth string, 5 to 7, third string, 5th fret, up to 7th, grace note slide into the 9, pedal off the second string, 8, back to 9 on third string, and then just hit the chord at the end. All right, let's jump into the second example. It's doing a lot of the same stuff. We have scale stuff happening at the front end of it, but then at the tail end of it, we're going to do something really special with a funky guitar chord idea. Check it out. One more time. So you can tell we got that scale line kicking it right from the start there. And then we're going to drop down from that scale line from 9 to 7 and then get this chord here at the 5th fret. It's another A minor triad. We hit it 2 times and then we do some scratch rhythms. That means we lift off our playing finger here on the fingerboard and we just let the notes sound muted for 2 hits. And then we come right back in on a quarter note on that chord once again. So it's a really cool effect. All right, let's get into the next two that I have for you. These are a little bit different because now what we're going to do is have the chord up front with this scale line idea happening after it. Here's the next example. One more time. So on this one, we have an A minor 7 chord that's hit right in the beginning. We do it 2 hits there. And then we have a scale line that's going to come off the 4th string with a hammer on 5 to 7. We play 5 into the 4th fret of the 3rd string, and then we're back on 4th string, 5th fret G there to take it to the end on a 7th fret, 5th string on the E note. So it's kind of a cool line there. It's a little bit disjointed too, somewhat syncopated. But it really comes together quite nice. And I like these ones too, where the chords up front really establishes the harmony of the measure quite nice. I got one more for you yet, and it goes like this. Sounds a bit Hendrix-y. So on this one, we've got an A minor triad chord up front. It sustains a little bit because it's lasting a beat and a half. And then we've got on the second string here a pull off from 8 to 5, then over to the third string, 7th fret, with a grace note slide to 9. So it's kind of a fast move up there to 9. And then we got the 5th fret note here coming in at the end. So a little bit down the Hendrix-y side with those pentatonic ideas. Okay, from the chord up front, sounds really nice. All right, so as you can tell, these things are a lot of fun. And once you integrate them into your playing, they sound flashy, they're nice for attention getting, but maybe you're still wondering, hey, how can I practice these things at home? What can I do to really fulfill my dreams of playing guitar like this? And I've got some of those ideas ready to go for you on the part 2 of this lesson. It's over on my Patreon. It's at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Over there, I'm gonna teach you actually like a practice method for how to build these things into your playing. And then the other thing I've got for you is an example of how this can get all fitted into a full-on tune. I wrote a composition for you that's a short 4-bar phrase going through a bunch of chords in the key of A minor, and it really comes together nice to help give a great example of how this can sound when you plug it into a chord progression. And a lot of professional guitar players, they'll use this just to kind of, well, I wouldn't want to say totally like to show off, but it's really just to kind of catch the listener's attention. That's one of the big factors that you're trying to do, especially with some lead playing when you're on stage. If you're trying to catch the listener's attention, maybe it's a vocal drop where you don't have anything going on from the singer, and maybe it's not really the place yet where you're going to do a full all-out solo or anything. These types of filler concepts, they sound excellent. Plus, if you love acoustic guitar, it works excellent from the perspective of acoustic playing because it helps you stand alone as a player, you know, as one instrument live in front of your audience. Now, I hope that you're going to join me next on Patreon. Over there, I've got tons of lessons. Whatever level that you join at, you're going to get access to over 400 guitar lessons over there. And the sign up is really cheap. You can get a basic sign up over there for $3 or $5. I also have the $15 all-inclusive package. Go check it out. You're going to really enjoy it over there. It's patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. On top of that, if you really need to buckle down on your chops and get your, you know, work together so you understand the fingerboard and the theory and all the compositional stuff, check out my website. It's a different website than Patreon. The address is creativeguitarstudio.com. Over there, I've got all of my courses. So if you want to study my beginner program, intermediate, advanced, maybe you want to get into like the acoustic guitar course, the rhythm guitar program, maybe you want to study music reading, maybe you want to do the ear training program, the songs program, guitar technique, guitar soloing, it's all over there for you, ready to go. The address, once again, is creativeguitarstudio.com. That's where all my courses are. I hope to see you next over on Patreon. One more time, that Patreon address is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part 2 video, I'm going to show you how to start adding these chord extras and scale frills played before and after the chords of a progression that I've created for you. It's a really easy to practice idea, and once you get it all tuned in, you're going to be sounding fantastic with this stuff. On top of that, I've got a great practice routine that's going to help you visualize the interaction of scales with chords on the neck. It's going to be really helpful for you. Plus, of course, like I mentioned earlier, I've composed that practice piece for you, and it's going to demonstrate just how cool this technique sounds when you use it. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you're going to get a jam track, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lesson. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.